Hello and welcome back. And in this video, we are going to talk about the binary operators, which you may are aware of, like or and negation. These are actually three binary operators which we use in our JavaScript code to execute a lot of things. So you may know that. Okay, so let me explain what are these operators. So x and y. So it's saying x or y. If one of them are true, then the execution will be true. Okay. Similarly, x and y, in this case, x and we call it as x and y. If both are true, then only it will be true. So what will happen in this case if x is true? That means the execution is true, right? Because it doesn't need to evaluate y again. If x is true, then it's fine. It will just return the true. If x is false, then it will directly return the false. Because if x is false and it is AND operator. So if any one of them is false, then it will be false. Okay. So it's like this. So false and true. If first expression is false, then it will not execute the second expression. Here, if it is true and false or whatever, so it will execute. If the first expression is true, then it will not execute the second expression. If first expression is false, then it will still execute the second expression because it need at least one as a true, and at least it need at least one expression as a false to exit. And to return the final result. So here in the both the false, it will be false, it will also false. Okay, so how can we use this to create our sandwich maker? We are going to write a JavaScript function, first JavaScript function. So what we are going to put in our sandwich is, let's just create a simple array. And what I'm going to put, I'm going to have onion and tomato. Okay, now I will write a function which will tell us that that particular sandwich is having tomato or onion or maybe both. Okay, so how to write a function in the JavaScript? So functions are just a basic functions. Functions are the set of instruction which we are using to execute particular set of commands and to return some output. Okay, so here till now we are just writing some statements. We are not collecting them and we are not putting them in some particular function. So function is a set of instruction which can be executed by other code and can be reused. So here I'm just creating a function. What I wanted to do here is, check sandwich is a function, and here I will pass the ingredient as an argument in the sandwich. So here you will pass, if ingredient is tomato, then you will return, okay, the tomato is the ingredient there. Okay. Now what we wanted to do, we wanted to run the for loop. So you will be passing either onion, tomato or something. Something else. Okay. So I will run the for loop onto the existing ingredients and we will try to know that that particular ingredient which you are passing in the function exists there or not. So I will come to know that what is the what type of sandwich you are making. So this we will talk in our coming sessions, that how we are actually writing the for in loop to run the iteration. Okay, so what we are going to do here is, here you will write expression, if the ingredient is equal to the passed ingredients, then so here you will also get a practice on the code. So here if it is true, then return true. Means whatever the ingredient which you passed in the function exists in the sandwich which you are making. Otherwise, if this is not true, then after the for loop, just return the false. Okay. Now, I wanted to know my sandwich is having that or not. So here I can call the sandwich check sandwich function. Check sandwich, and I will pass the ingredient, which is onion, right? Or here I can use these operators, check sandwich, and I will pass the another argument, which is, and here I can write, okay, yes, whatever I was looking for, this is a particular sandwich. So you can see this is onion tomato sandwich. Right? Else if here you can put a loop. So this is actually a OR operator. If it is onion or if it is a tomato, then I'm saying it's an onion OR tomato sandwich. If you are saying if both are true, then only you can say if it is onion and tomato sandwich, it means it is having both of them. Okay, so this is how I am calling that function in the if or if expression. So what is the if look like? If we'll have expression, this expression can represent to some variable, can represent to some function call. So here if it is returned, this function is returning true and this function is returning true for tomato and onion both, then only you can say this is the sandwich which is having onion and tomato both, right? The check sandwich is a function, and here we have created our first array which is having the onion, tomato and blah blah, and you are calling this function and you are checking that that particular ingredient which you passed exists in the sandwich or not. Okay, so we use the for of loop, so we also check about the condition, right? So this is if condition for, and we create a function, we initialize some variables. For now let's put it as a var expression only, because we haven't talked about let only. Okay, so this is how we write these conditional operators. So here you can just nested them, you can create a and b, a or b, a and b, and nested expressions, and you can just come to know how the operators behaves in JavaScript. These are like same operators, a and b, a or b, a and b, then again or with some other expression. That's it. So in the next video we'll talk more about the basic stuff.